warning, the violence of war shattered the peaceful celebration of the Lunar New Year through a simultaneous attack by the communists on many of the cities throughout South Vietnam. On the second day of Tet, the ancient capital of Wei was hit by a mass attack. Heavily populated areas and South Vietnamese Army barracks were hit with heavy gun and rocket fire. By taking advantage of the Tet truce, the communists had infiltrated their forces into the old capital. They soon established themselves in the citadel and in strategic spots throughout the city. The 324th Division of the North Vietnamese Army had been given the task of taking Hue. Its 4th Regiment attacked from the northwest down the left bank of the Perfume River, while the 6th Regiment moved up the opposite side of the river, attacking from the southwest. The citadel itself was seized by a North Vietnamese battalion. Its headquarters was established at the Dong Ba Gate. These scenes were shot by Army photographer Vinh Dang after his capture by the Viet Cong. He was rescued by South Vietnamese troops a short while later. Moving out of their stronghold in the citadel, the communists attempted to gather people at the Dong Ba Gate and on Phan Boi Chau Street. There they hoped to disseminate their propaganda. However, the people of Hue knew about previous communist lies and contradictory statements. Wherever the communists went, the people fled. All that greeted the advancing communist troops were block after block of empty houses. Many homes were entered and searched, only to find the inhabitants had fled through back doors moments before. The people of Hue scurried out of the city to South Vietnamese Army positions for protection. The enemy battalion commander watched despondently as his hopes for popular support faded with each refugee who fled the old walled city. He ordered an entire block of homes burned in retaliation. However, his acts of retaliation were short-lived. South Vietnamese aircraft soon appeared on the horizon and began raining tons of bombs on enemy positions. At the same time, the Arvin 1st Infantry Division began its counterattack. Two battalions of the 3rd Regiment were sent to rescue Hue. Wherever the Arvin troops appeared, the refugees rallied to them for protection as communist guns opened fire. The Arvin troops quickly returned fire on the enemy. Jets appeared overhead and began providing fire support to cover the advance of the Marines and airborne troops. Fired at each target prior to the attack, allowing the populace a chance to escape. Communist plans to use the people as shields during the fighting were spoiled. Artillery was called in to prevent the enemy's withdrawal. Plans were then formulated for attacking the next objective. This was an enemy stronghold on the citadel wall. As government soldiers approached the communist positions, enemy gunfire raked their lines. The approach was difficult, for the enemy held the high ground. Braving the fire, Arvin soldiers advanced and soon overwhelmed the enemy. Hundreds of enemy bodies were found still in their foxholes. Scattered around them were weapons and supplies of all kinds. Many boxes of ammunition had never been opened. Chinese and Russian-made anti-aircraft guns, machine guns, and rocket launchers were among the weapons captured by the victorious soldiers. The communists had reaped for themselves only a harvest of death and destruction.